The modern advancements that overtook jobs that were essential at the time all share one thing in common. No one saw them coming. Imagine if you were in the early 1900s editing encyclopedias. You would have thought the sound of Wikipedia, or what Wikipedia is crazy. And the tech industry is no different. Jobs that used to be essential are becoming obsolete. But there is a flip side to this. As rapid advancements continue to grow in technology, the opportunity to grow with technology and grow our skills with technology exists. Think back to 100 years ago. What were the most popular jobs back then? Well, for one, farming was a big one. Imagine farming without the technology we have today. It was more about the number of people that they could actually get to help, the number of hands that could help. And when technology came along, farming and a lot of the jobs that went along with it left. Actually, fun fact for you, over 100 years ago, there was double the amount of machinists and toolmakers needed. Thanks to automation and increasing advancements in technology, a lot of these jobs became obsolete. And there are so many more examples just like this. Think about the advent of renewable energy and how many jobs that cut for miners and coal mine workers. Mass-produced fast fashion largely overtook independent seamstresses, automobiles replaced horse-drawn carriage, and the list goes on. And it really encompasses every industry. So who are we in the tech industry to think that we are untouchable? Because we're definitely not. I feel like I'd be doing this list injustice if I didn't list this one first, which is cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is no longer a nice to have or a want. It is a need. It's an essential need for all companies if they are hoping to grow and survive. And cybersecurity, the stats around it on how many jobs are needed that are not filled right now, if you are looking for a job, look no further. It is so in demand, not only now, but it will continue to be in the future. And cybersecurity is one of those things, this area, this whole bubble of cybersecurity that whether you are an engineer, a cybersecurity specialist, an analyst, there is a role for you. And you might be asking, Tiff, well, how do I get into cybersecurity? Do I have to go back to school? Do I have to go back to university? And the answer is no. There are so many different roles within cybersecurity that you do not need to go back to school for, that you don't need to learn how to code for. I mean, hey, if you are a coder and you want to get into cybersecurity, it is a great, great thing to do. And there's a lot of courses that I'll list some here that really help you get up and running with that. But going back to school or doing formal learning doesn't have to be the only way in order to get into cybersecurity. And it's one of those things that even as more jobs become automated, cybersecurity will actually continue to go up and up in demand, because as things become automated, the need for cybersecurity, the need to prevent hacking and predict hackings that are coming up will become more and more in demand. So cybersecurity, I would say, is the safest bet. If you are someone who really wants to get in an industry, like a secure industry, the way to go. And next up is the cloud. And well, we kind of are in the clouds right now. I'll do a little screenshot. We ended up going on a little bit of a trip and I'm finishing the video or parts of the video with you on vacation, because why not? The cloud, whether it be engineering, whether it be analysts, the cloud is growing. Actually, I recently did a blog article on the cloud, and companies that are adopting to the cloud, it's 97%. So the cloud not only is currently in demand, but the future is going in the direction of the cloud. Imagine even before we had this, you know, everyone was locked down, shut down from home, the cloud was already going in that direction, but it really accelerated the pace of it since the lockdown happened, since we have been at home for so many years now, it feels like. I mean, now things are opening up, of course, but that really accelerated the cloud, and the cloud is going to continue, based on data, based on numbers, to be so in demand. And of course, cloud engineers, analysts, another great thing for clouds as well is developer advocates. They really fit into the cloud because there are so many roles that they can play as far as educating other developers about the cloud. Next on the list, and I'm sure there's no surprise here, is AI and machine learning. And now you might be saying, Tiff, well, is that kind of a twofold though? Because is AI and AI engineers or AI experts really going to be in demand? Because the more we create AI, the more AI can create itself and it's self-sufficient. We're looking way too far ahead here. The reality is, now and in the future, skills around AI, artificial intelligence, machine learning, whether you are an AI engineer, whether you are a software engineer specializing in AI, anything like that, will continue to be more and more in demand. Whew. Excuse me, I'm a little bit out of breath. We're in the mountains right now, and the elevation, it's actually like, they say it makes it harder to breathe if you're not used to it, and it really does. And you know, we could keep on going with this list with cybersecurity, AI, data science, coding in general, a ton of soft skills, But I wanted to do something fun where I list a little bit of put you into this world where it's the future and specific roles that pertain to the topics we spoke about today and really get you to visualize what the future of jobs, what the future of work could look like. Jobs in the future that don't exist today. Okay, well, the first one that I've read about, which I think is really interesting, is an aerospace taxi. So taking people from Earth to Mars to the moon, and it happens very quickly. This one though really stood out to me because we're really not that far away in the grand scheme of things that something like this could happen. Another one that really stood out to me is a hologram graphic or hologram fashion designer. And this one stood out to me because it actually exists today. As far as if you think about the metaverse and all the video games out there, different things like that, and with holographics coming to be such a huge thing, the reality is that designers, fashion designers in that area focusing on fashion in the metaverse is going to continue to be a huge thing as major brands continue to break into that area. Another one on the list that I can just like, I have such a strong visual for is manager of robots. So this isn't robots managing you, it's you managing robots. So really what that is, or entails anyways, is the description they gave is imagine you're going into Starbucks, you're walking into Starbucks and there's a robot working. Maybe it's in the form of a tablet, or maybe it's in the form of a human, however you want to look at it. But who's managing those robots is a human, you know, making sure they're doing what they're told, they're functioning accordingly. And that to me was so interesting. Now, will this actually become a thing? Maybe, I'm not certain, but it's very fun to look ahead to the future at jobs that do not exist today, but the trends that they're kind of leading towards that they might exist. I'm curious on that note though, what are some jobs that don't exist today that you think might exist in the future? Leave in the comments below. Let's have some fun with this. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video going through what jobs and really what sectors in tech are going to continue to be so in demand in the future. And I really like doing these kind of videos, looking ahead based on data, based on numbers, based on the demand as to what sectors or roles in those sectors will become more and more in demand. Because I know a lot of you are either in tech or wanting to break into tech, and having an understanding of the kind of direction you can skew your career to make sure it stays in demand and that you stay really relevant with your skills. Tech in general, you're going to have to always be learning and evolving if you want to stay in demand. And as long as you are learning the right things that we just spoke about today, areas we spoke about today, you as a person will continue to be in demand. So I really don't want this video to scare you that, oh, if I'm not in one of these sectors, I won't be in demand. No, just start maybe shifting your learning to one of these sectors is a great way to go. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it very helpful and valuable. Leave in the comments other topics you want me to cover, other questions you have. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career-based videos, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.